First of all, I want to thank the expert panel members for the hard work they did, the time they spent doing it. It was a great contribution to the transit debate that we're having today. When I first came to council, I was very clear about my position on Eglinton, but I wasn't as of yet decided on what the right transit technology would be for Sheppard. So what I did is I started doing my own research. And I compared it to the rhetoric that I heard from those who have advocated for a subway. And what I understand to be true is this. Those who have said that the maintenance costs are greater for LRTs than subways are either mistaken or just giving you misinformation, that it's actually cheaper to maintain LRTs rather than subways. As well, the life cycle components. LRT versus subway. An LRT, the car is 30 years. A subway is also 30 years. The track, LRT, 25 years. The subway, 25 years. Signal systems, LRT, 50 years. Subway, 50 years. A number of the arguments that people in Scarborough and across the city are hearing about why a subway makes more sense on this corridor of Sheppard than LRT are just being misinformed. That's based on the evidence that I've seen. Now, I appreciate Councillor Del Grande making an effort today to say, listen, let's find revenue tools to fund transit. I appreciate that, and I want to consider revenue tools to fund transit. But I need two things. I need a plan that is both fiscally responsible, but also is evidence-based and considers things such as current and future ridership projections and where there's allowable density. Now, I've raised this here before. I'm not convinced that there is the density, the allowable density, the soft sites along the commercial strip of the Sheppard Corridor based on the evidence that I've seen to support this plan. I'm not convinced that, and also I'm really concerned that there'd be high density needed that would go into the local residential neighborhoods that there really has been no consultation with Scarborough residents about the possibility of 30 to 50 story buildings. And that conversation needs to be had. I'd want it for my community if that was under consideration. And I think Scarborough residents deserve that too. I also believe that we need to pick our projects based on evidence. There are places, every major city I know does prefer subways in their cores where there is the density that supports them. But major cities like Paris, for example, are building LRTs in their suburban areas. There are cities across the world, over 100 that I've seen, that are doing the same thing. So I don't think it's true to say, you know, subways are always better or LRTs are always better or vice versa. We need to contextualize the discussion. We need to be thoughtful about it and really consider where are we talking about and what are we talking about. Now, I support personally, I think that a relief line that would be focused into the core of the city that would support Scarborough and other residents coming into work if they choose to come downtown and going back home makes sense, and we need to consider revenue tools for that. I also believe that we need to extend the Eglinton Crosstown to Pearson Airport. We're the only major city in the world that I know of that doesn't have a rapid transit link to their major airport. I also think, and this hasn't been discussed much, and it should, about the current need to deal with good repair and the overcrowding on the Yonge and University lines that we currently have on the today. Ultimately, we are about to have a budget discussion soon for 2013. And it just amazes me that the very people who wanted to freeze property tax just a couple years ago, who are saying, let's just get rid of the vehicle registration tax, now let's get rid of the land transfer tax, let's get rid of every revenue source we have, all of a sudden, there's something they want, and let's just think of every possible tax we've ever heard of. Let's do this well. Let's do this maturely. Let's actually think this out before we just start asking taxpayers to reach deeper in their pockets. I don't mind doing that if it makes sense, but I've got to justify to the taxpayer who I request that from. ultimately, please support the panel's recommendations. They have evidence behind them. I haven't seen any other plan today that does.